From growing up in the DRC.
Imagine being in a house in the middle of the city, a nice modern house by a big fat mango tree in the garden. Come on, man, I had a good time.
To becoming a global king of comedy.
Eddie Kadi!
Eddie Kadi has had an incredible journey.
In Congo, we learned how to speak English in capital letters.
And he sat down to tell me all about it.
Eddie, welcome to London.
Thank you.
I was born in the Congo, and I'm both British and African, and I'm proud of both cultures.
But you are living here, right?
Yeah. You know, so you're long overdue. You've just decided to welcome me. Oh, come on, Ben, man. Thank you for having me, finally.
Thank you for being there.
You know, it's funny, because I'm always like, I came over to... I didn't come over. Like, I didn't make that decision at the age of 8. I was happily running around in Congo, having a great time with a big family, and then... My mum was like, we're going, and then we never came back.
But it must be hard to balance being British and Congolese, right?
My parents have never stopped speaking to me Lingala, our mother tongue, never stopped. You know, my brother and sister, my siblings, they were born here, they speak it fluently. But we just kind of lived in Congo in our household in Fulham, West London.
Every African we've spoken to that has reached heights of success has been to university and done something completely different to what they're doing now.
Media technology was what I was studying. We are constantly being told, this is who you're going to be, a doctor. You know, I remember they say, be a doctor. I said, Dad, I can't be a doctor. It's too late. With what I'm trying. But I said, at least be a vet. Eh? You've seen your mom cutting chicken in the kitchen. Cut a chicken.
Check the rice. Don't you know it's a special rice? It's also called jollof rice. Yeah, man.
What a job. It must be amazing to make people laugh all the time.
The best thing about being a comedian, being able to change people's lives you've never met before and probably never meet again. And like maybe 10 years down the line, you might meet someone in a supermarket and they'll be like, I had a really bad day. That day I came to watch you. My boyfriend dumped me that very day, you know, and I just felt like I was in love again.
But what if people don't find you funny?
That's happened to me before. In fact, if it's never happened to you, you're not a comedian, because that's how you improve. Every comedian has died on stage, where you're cracking jokes and all you're hearing is, oh, yo. She's bouncing off walls.
Oh, yeah, I'm cringing
no,
just thinking
listen,
about it.
Listen, as in your audience is that is. Mannequin challenge. Yeah, I've had that before.
In fact, at one of Eddie's first shows, his own dad didn't laugh.
So I'm watching my dad and my dad's just doing this. He's looking around going, everyone's laughing, he's just doing this. So I thought, what's going on? So at the end of the show, it really hurt me, right? I was coming to my dad, I said, like, you're really stubborn. Like, did you not enjoy the show? So Eddie, it was wonderful.
What?
Thank you. He said, it was fantastic. I had a great time. You are talented. I remember, Dad, you didn't laugh. He said, Eddie, how can I laugh? I was too busy counting the money. £20, £20, £20. I said, well, you go, this is a good career. We will make a lot of cash.
Yeah, man, A to the D. Hey, you don't know about me.
If a young person's watching this and they want to do what you do, what do they need to do?
Whatever you're feeling inside, that's God talking to you. You know, that's your purpose talking to you. Ignore everything else and focus on that, and the truth will always prevail.